Welcome once again to Sami and Mathematics. We've been having a calculus series and we've had up to 12 series, and this is Implicit Differentiation, one of the series we're discussing. What do we really mean by implicit differentiation? In calculus, we must understand what we mean by an explicit function. So if we have a function y equals to f of x, this function is actually called an explicit function because we simply have one dependent variable and we have the independent variable on either side of the equality sign. So this is referred to as the explicit function. Explicit function. But on the other hand, we may not have it like this all the time. We can have something like f of xy equals to zero. In a case like this, that is an example there which we are going to solve. We have a combined function, we have x and y combined. So we call this an implicit function. So this is implicit in nature. So this is an implicit function. Now the truth is that it may not always be two variables. This is just implicit function in two variables, x and y, just two variables. You can have x, y, z, and all that. Those will now start giving what we call the functions of several variables. Functions of several variables. I'm going to do a video on that. Now, let's go back to this so that we can solve this. Now, solution, the first thing we will understand is that to solve this, you have to differentiate everything. You have to differentiate everything. When you differentiate the function of x, you put the x over the x. When you differentiate the function of y, you denote it as dy dx. Now let's do that together. If we differentiate this, we're going to have, you remember this, we're going to have 6x squared. Please, you can recall the video on the polynomials, I explained that. So this is 6x squared, that's 3 times 2, and 3 minus 1 will give us this. We are going to write here dx, dx. Plus, this is a different case because we have product rule there. So we are going to treat that as a product. We are going to keep x constant and differentiate y. Remember product rule. Differentiate y, we are going to have 1. And we are going to write there the y, the x. Why? Because we differentiated the function of y. So on the other hand, we are going to have plus y being kept constant. In this case, then we differentiate x. Then here we can have the x over the x. It's saying, okay, if you put the x over the x here, there's no problem. So this is for product rule. This is simply product rule. Take note, product rule. Where we keep one variable, differentiate the other, we keep this other variable and differentiate the other. Now this will be minus. Differentiating this will be minus 6y, that's 2 times 3 and 2 minus 1, and we have that. Then we have dy dx because we differentiated the function of y. This will be equal to 0, why? Because the derivative of the constant is actually equal to 0. So let's simplify this. This is going to give us 6x squared, this is 1, dx by dx is 1, plus 3x dy dx, opening the bracket, plus 3y, this is 1, minus 6y dy dx equals to 0. So from there, all we need to do is to collect like terms. These and these are like terms, so we can collect them and have 3x minus 6y dy dx. And on the other side, we can move this and this to the other side to have minus into 3y plus 6x squared. So, dividing both sides by this, we can have dy, the x, can have dy, the x, to give us minus into 3y plus 6x squared divided by 3x minus 6y. So this is actually the slope to that function, or we can say the derivative to the function we have there. So this is the derivative of the function we have there. All we now need to do is to substitute 1 and 2. So we are finding the slope at the point 1 and 2. And at 1 and minus 2, precisely, the y, the x, will be equal to minus into 3 into minus 2 plus 6 into 1 squared divided by 3 into 1 minus 6 into minus 2. And that will give us 6 minus 6, and that is 0. That is 0 divided by 3 plus 12, and that is 15. And that will end up giving us 0. So the slope of this particular function is actually equals to 0. So if we are to have a gradient to that curve, it's actually a curve, the slope is going to be equals to 0. So that's the implicit differentiation for you. You can always email me any question that bothers you. I'm going to solve and make a video on it. Thank you very much. Remember to share and also like. Bye.